Okay, friends, let's see if we get a little bit of audio here. Okay, get everything set up here. Here's my contact information. For those of you that haven't joined the live stream before or are catching this on the replay, you could reach me at mr.paul.angeli@gmail.com, and that will be for any type of inquiry, or if you have a if you're look or a production studio looking for a storyboard artist, there's my email contact there. You could also find my website at www. PaulAngeli.com, and my Instagram handle, YouTube channel, LinkedIn information's right there for you. Awesome. Hi everybody, how y'all doing? I hope you guys are having a wonderful Saturday night. I love Saturdays because it's our jam sessions, and I love these sessions. They're fun to do, and fun to hang out with you good folks and enjoy our time together. So I appreciate you joining in. If you're just joining the chat or just joining up, say hello in the chat. I'd love to see who's on the broadcast right now. A few of you got back to me via Instagram to let me know if you're going to be able to jump on or not, and really appreciate that and taking the time. So I will catch you in the next live session. But if you're watching right now, please drop a line in the live chat, and I'd love to say hello. Cool. I hope everybody's doing well tonight. Start to get a couple things set here. We'll get started here. Get my notes here. Let's get started. Okay. Well, hi everybody. Welcome to our storyboard jam session. My name is Paul Angeli. I'm a live action storyboard artist, and I started this YouTube channel about I would say it's getting close about a month and a half ago. And I really appreciate everybody checking into the channel and kicking the tires on this to see where it could go. I just started it just a little while ago, and we're well over 400 subscribers already. And that's actually, I'm so just honored and thrilled and humbled that you guys are taking the time to follow this work and that you're very interested in storyboarding and the art of visual storytelling, telling stories through your images. I'm having a good time doing that and bringing this information to you, and I hope you guys are learning a lot. I've been seeing a lot of folks great artwork, and they're submitting it to me over on my Instagram handle at mr.paul.angeli, and I just really appreciate everybody sharing their artwork. So tonight I was trying to do something different and come up with some crazy ideas. What's fun about these jam sessions is that I just come up with whatever idea I'm playing around with, and we talk a little bit about the filmography and film history of the topics that we're learning about, and go ahead and sort of put together a storyboard sequence. I don't have a script I'm working off. I sort of just go on the fly and have some fun with it, drawing some sharks. And for this one, we're doing a shark week. Sort of basing our idea off of great white sharks. So we'll see where it sort of goes. But just to give you a little bit, I've been having fun with these live streams and bringing these live streams to you. Let me bring up this real quick screen here. This one here. And this is sort of showing the programming that I have going on for you good folks. each week in terms of the strategy and the content that I'm trying to provide. I do this on for fun and for my own time and have some fun with you guys. So, anyways, sort of how I break it down is on Tuesdays, every Tuesday, about the same time, we're doing storyboarding. I call it storyboarding, mastering the basics. What are the basic things that you at home need to know how to do, or you as a pro out there, what are those things that you need to touch base on to enhance that toolbox of skills? I try to keep it more basic right now for a lot of people that are interested in the art of storyboarding. And so I call it storyboarding, mastering the basics. And I think we've done quite a few different live streams over this, whether it be composition, shots, angles, camera movement. We did a whole take on how to break down your shot list based off a script. We went over to Instagram real quick and did a live session real quick on how to break that shot list and script into thumbnails. I'll try to get it when I get a chance. I'll try to redo that again here on YouTube so we can provide it and I can provide that information to you. But Tuesdays are fantastic. It's a great introduction into storyboarding and sort of the technical parts of storyboarding. And Thursdays, we have our sketching after hours. Sketching after hours is just sort of a place to hang out. Grab your sketchbook, have that sketchbook, have your pens, whichever way. I've seen everybody do it all different types of ways. But just hang out with other fellow storyboard artists and learn how to storyboard and sort of work on those sketching skills. This last week we did a whole we focused on dinosaurs, and so we drew all the different types of dinosaurs. You can see I have a little snippet clip that I put into Instagram, a little quick reel. You can see all the artwork, or you can tune in and watch that live stream, here on the replay on my channel. So check that out. And then on Saturdays, like I said, is our storyboard jam session. Storyboard jam sessions were sort of a chance where we're going to put together all those things that we've been working on, both on the learning side and on the sketching side. We're going to put those all together into a storyboard together for it. And when I have extra time, I try to put those shots together into a quick little animatic so we can sort of review what we've created on the Saturday night. So that's sort of the lineup: Tuesdays, Thursdays, and Saturdays. If you want to check out the Storyboarding Mastering the Basics, I got a playlist for that also on my channel. Sketching After Hours, I still got to make the playlist for that, but then you can watch all those and just sketch along. If you're feeling like, hey, I have sort of an artist block, go ahead, watch some of those. Get interested, get busy, get back into it. And then, of course, Saturdays, you can watch the replays on our storyboard jam session. So awesome stuff. Again, I thank you all for joining me tonight. Again, my name is Paul Angeli. I'm a live action storyboard artist coming to you from Pennsylvania. And thank you so much for joining me and being with me tonight. So thanks for joining up. So today we're going to be talking about great white sharks. It's a natural predator in the ocean. I grew up in the in California and grew up. I learned how to boogie board and surfing and everything, and that's sort of over there in Capitola, right next to Santa Cruz. There was a lot of I guess great white shark activity too when I was learning how to do all that stuff. But anyways, fun days back on the beach in the ocean, and I think it's a great animal, and it's something fun to draw, as well as it's piqued the interest of a lot of movie and film goers over the years. So let's talk about film and about this wonderful, crazy creature that has come all the way from the past and hung out with us. Since the time of the dinosaurs, in different fashions as it is in terms of so many different species of shark today. But let's go back and talk a little bit about our film and our film history when it comes to sharks. I remember old movies like James Bond and Thunderball and stuff like that, and they'd have the big shark pit, and the bad guy would throw whoever was needed to get eaten by the sharks, throw them into the shark, I guess, pit to get eaten up, But anyways, there's some funky memories and films. But I think the most epic film that came out when it came to sharks was 1975's Jaws. Boy, that blew the records in so many different ways, and we'll talk about that. But that movie was directed by Steven Spielberg, and if you ever got a chance to watch that movie, I know I've seen it many, many times, but if you ever get a chance to watch it, it's worth a watch. And Steven Spielberg based it off, got the rights to a 1974 novel by Peter Benchley, and got the made the movie. It had a lot of production issues with the shark mechanically not working correctly, and Steven was a wise director and worked through all of that and all those headaches. And some of those things came out to be some of the most fantastic, dramatic and suspenseful sequences with this great white shark. And the movie starred Roy Scheider, as the police chief Brody. You had Richard Dreyfuss as the marine biologist. You had Robert Shaw, the great Robert Shaw, as the shark hunter. He had Murray Hamilton as the mayor, and Lorraine Gray as Brody's wife. And this movie is a, I think it was one of the very first blockbusters. And if you can, a little piece of film knowledge, it was the highest grossing movie at the time. So this came out in 1975. And then on top of that, to add all the seasoning to these great artists working together to create bring this fictional shark alive, was John, the score from John Williams. Just hearing that dun 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 dun, and I guess every beginner piano player like myself, when I was a kid, you're just sitting there tapping on the keys trying to recreate John Williams' fantastic score, going, oh, that's from Jaws. So that's absolutely fantastic. And then not until Star Wars came out in 1978 did it topple and blow away past the being the highest grossing movie after Jaws. But Jaws went on to spin off quite a few sequels after that, but also it laid the groundwork for a lot of other future films that we see starring sharks, or featuring sharks. I go back, it wasn't a shark movie, but it was a great white, or excuse me, it wasn't a shark movie, but it was a killer whale movie that came out in 1977 called Orca. I remember that coming out and always, oh, Orca, But there was always a mystery about ocean and oceanography, because when I was growing up, you most you got is the reels, besides movies, is the reels from Jacques Cousteau, and seeing underwater footage like that, So from that movie, there was quite a few different movies. I know in 1999 they came out with a. There's always been a series, but I'm sort of picking out some of the movies I've seen over the years. You had d 1999. You had the Deep Blue Sea that started Sam Jackson. Another movie going in through there. You had another movie in 2003 called Open Water with sharks in it. I know there were a couple of the 47 Meters Down movies, in 2017 and 2019 that came out. Other movies series that came out was Sharknado. This is like a made-for-TV type of movie series. But and I know my youngest son just loved this Sharknado series. So we watched a lot of Sharknado. I think they came up with the Sharknado. With six different sequels in the Sharknado, and I think I've seen them all. But anyway, I know Blake Lively did the Shallows in 2016, and they started going animated too. Shark Tale in 2004, a lot of famous actors in that one, voicing characters. I know Will Smith was the lead in that one, but there's a lot of great actors voicing different characters. Jack Black, I think there was all different people in that movie. You had Finding Nemo and the sharks from Finding Nemo. Brucey, here comes Brucey. So they had all different things there. And another one I know just came out too was the Meg just came out again, but this was the Meg first hit the scene coming out of that trench to you got prehistoric megalodons and stuff like that. But Jason Statham starred in that film where he's fighting the giant megalodon, called the Meg in 2018. I think they just did a Meg 2 starring Jason again. So you have a long history now, of shark movies and having fun with those shark movies. So anyways, I always try to give a little bit of film history, a little bit of what do you call it, trivia stuff like that to get going on these sharks and have some fun with it. Let's see who's in the chat, who can hang out with us tonight. I got Gabby. Hey Gabby, how you doing? Gabby says hello and good evening. Hey Gabby, I hope everything's doing well. I hope you're getting ready to draw some sharks, my friend. Drawing some sharks. So very cool. Again, thank you for joining me if you're on the live stream. And if you're catching this in the replay, follow along. Go ahead and draw. Fill up that sketchbook. Draw your own sequence based on what we're doing. And I really appreciate you taking your time out of your busy day to come and watch me draw and watch me storyboard as we storyboard together. I got Bharat. Bharat's giving me a hand wave there. Hey, Bharat, how you doing? I hope you had a great holiday and festival over there in India. And I'm glad you're able to join us today. Good to see you, my friend. And we're going to get started here. With our jam sessions, I've been having a good time. Like I say, I sort of do this on the fly and make up a story. Don't really, I'm not going off a script and just going off imagination and just playing around with what's in my mind's eye as we're storyboarding and get going. So a couple things that I always do. Tonight I am drawing in Photoshop. I know we've done a couple old school sessions in our jab sessions as well, where I am drawing on paper and just pen, Sharpies, and paper. I don't use anything fancy or any type of fancy marker. Just to show you real quick, I'm using just a Sharpie and a what is this? A Bic round stick. Just the simple pens, and that's it. I try not to use pencil too much. I think when you're drawing, I want to be committed to that drawing. So if I'm just sketching or I'm just doing some rough storyboards on paper, and there's a couple reasons why I always suggest and talk about pens or just simple tools. Number two pencil, or if you have a mechanical pencil of some sort. I tend to use these tools, the simplest tools, because if I'm sitting down with a director, I'm sitting down with a client, I want to be able just to sketch it out right there. I know we have iPads and different software we can do that more mobile, and it's hard to bring your Cintiq or whatever with you. But my goal it always is for myself. And I share it because it's just my how I work is I want to be able to draw in front of the client. Whether it be the director or the client themselves, whether if I'm sketching out a music video, something for animation, live action, off the shooting script or whatever it might be, but I want to be able just to rattle it off right there. Some of our some of these films, you look at something like what Ridley Scott does, or Steven Spielberg. They're sitting there just drawing. They're not using any fancy tools. They have the shots. They have the editing already sort of staged in their head, and they're taking the time. And a lot of these great directors know how. They're artists themselves, and go ahead and they sketch these things out. And I think it what's beautiful about it is it gives you your first draft at the movie visually, and that's what excites me about being a storyboard artist is I get to be the first director, the camera itself, and creating what these sequences and these shots could be and look like, and it's exciting for me. And that's the you're putting together the blueprint along with the screenplay writers or writer or writers or the director and the creatives on the project to launch this thing. So everybody everybody's using this blueprint and doing their part to bring this creative project together. It's not just one person that brings us all together. It's a multi unit creative team, from sound to costuming to special effects to stunts to acting to directing. There's all these different elements that make a great movie, and you know which ones that you love, that you cherish, that mean something to you. And it takes a lot of talented people, and you know, we're doing our part to help to bring that that movie magic alive. And so anyway, so I use this basic tool so I can go and, you know, draw and just write then and there. You know, yes, we have Photoshop. Yes, we have Storyboard Pro. We have all these different tools we can use. Grease pencil, you know, Blender's grease pencil tool, and all these different things. But they're just tools. You still need to have a creative individual creating these fantastic imagery, you know, and these scenes. And there's so much of a rich history of filmmaking, not only in the United States, from across the world, you know, and then some fantastic filmmaking going on. And it's always great to watch films, draw from films, do those things to learn your craft. And that's where I hope I'm bringing it home for you good folks at home, is, and you know, watching here on the YouTube channel, is that you're building those skills at home, you know. That's why I take the time to talk about, you know, sketching and building that pencil mileage up, and building that acumen of knowledge. So you don't, you know, yeah, we do use reference material. Yes, we do, you know, look at those things. But just to be able to rip it off real quick of what you're trying to do, you got to have those basic drawing skills. So with that said, let's get started. Let's draw some sharks for a little bit. Let's warm up a little bit, and let's get going and get this thing started. I'm gonna take a sip of my coffee here, and because I'm gonna start storyboarding, I'm gonna start telling some stories. So I hope everybody's having a good evening. Gabby, Barat, hope you're doing well yourselves, friends. And let's draw some sharks. Okay, so, you know, when I'm thinking of sharks and those type of things, I think I talked about it during our our session on Thursday, is to, when you're drawing, think of those, we were drawing dinosaurs and stuff, and you just kind of think of those simple shapes, you know, in terms of what you're doing. Everything sort of starts in those simple shapes. You got, you know, circles, triangles, squares, you know, rectangles, you got ovals, you know. There's all different, you know, different shapes, and everything is based on a shape. So if I'm quote unquote drawing a shark or something like that, you know, let me throw another layer on here real quick. Use a different color. Maybe thicken this line up as well. I'm always thinking of shapes, and it's like, is, you know, here you go, it's sort of an oval here. Here's a triangle, here's a triangle, 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 triangle. And you sort of put it together, you know? And you're thinking about how those things, you know, how does that shark look? And here, if I'm doing a shark head, it's pretty much just triangles, right? It's a triangle here, you know, in terms of, it's all triangles, right? And you can sort of look at the you know, if you have the head and it's a triangle here like that, and the triangle in the back, and then it's a rectangle in the middle, right? And you have another triangle, 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 and here's your shark. You know, it's simple shapes and in terms of what you're doing. And like I say, you know, I've been drawing for many, many years, so you just go and knock it out, you know. But when you're learning how to draw, if you're thinking about these simple shapes, it makes your life easier in terms of, because, like I said, don't fall in love with your drawing. I don't know if this is going to be used or not, in terms of, you know, what's gonna hit the screen, or what's gonna be shared with the other teams, you know, and you know, so if, I wouldn't add a lot of detail. I try to keep it sort of simple. I know in these, I have fun drawing, so I'll sit there and do it. But if I'm really thinking about it, it's like if you're thinking about those simple shapes, I'm drawing this same shark like that. You can just look at these simple shapes in terms of what we're doing. Even if I just drew a rectangle here, but that's pretty much your shark, you know? And let's lower the opacity of that really. So we can see this. There's that shark here. Here's its eye. It has its gill plates, and you can add to it, and there's your shark, you know? If I wanted to add some sort of grayscale to it or something, you know, I could just simply just go grab that shark outline. Doesn't have to be very complicated or anything. Okay, so there it is. Okay, let's go back to our blocks. Boom. Knock it down about right there. Add another layer as we're drawing this shark. Let's try one more layer up on top. We got something like that. Let's add the other layer on top. Boom. Possibly get rid of the red, and you already have your pretty much your shark there. Using that simple, there's your sort of your outline of your shark we simply just created. And you can simply just add the eyes. You have the shark right there, add those gill plates. There's your simple shark of what you're doing, okay? So it doesn't take very much to draw that shark. So if you're thinking about it, think of those simple shapes that we were just talking about, you know? It just makes it so simple for you. If you need to color code it or something like that, let's just say we're gonna blue. A little bit bigger here. Blue is a rectangle. Maybe green is all the fins. These are just triangles. Pick another color and let's go yellow. So out of some simple shapes, you have your shark ready to rock and roll. So let me do this. Let's grab all this stuff here. Group this together. So again, back to my sharkies here. What do you think about Robert Shaw? cool. So we got some sharks here. I drew right before the session started to get some ideas flowing and get the creative juices flowing. How's the drawing going, everybody? Barat, Gabby, how's the drawing going? You get the basics of the shark down? You got that? You guys got that? Are you at home watching on the replay? You got that down? Drawing those simple shapes to get your sharks drawn? Great. Let's see here. Just checking the chat real quick. Okay, let's start drawing. Let's see what type of story are we gonna tell today? How are we gonna do it? Get my blacks on here. Okay, yeah, Gabby is drawing. Awesome, awesome, awesome. Okay, so I have some storyboard picture frames already drawn out here. So where are we gonna go? Are we gonna take place on the beach? Are we gonna take place in the ocean? You know what's interesting? When I'm thinking of shots, I don't have the shot up, but it's pretty cool. I love. Let me just throw an extra layer on here. Grab this guy right here. Let me just grab this guy right here. Close that down. Bring that guy. I drawn this shark over here, but what was sort of cool about this guy? No, my shark. There we go. Guess I can have it closed down. One of the things I was thinking about with this particular shot is I remember the shot from the Meg. That was really cool. I liked it. You had this overpowered shark like that. Then in front of that shark, something like that. In the foreground, tighten that down a little bit. In that foreground, you had to. I think it was a was a little girl just sitting there. Looking at the shark. Where the shark appeared, she was playing and then turned around, or something like that. Something like that. You're showing the size comparison. There's a lot of story going on. I just drawn this out of my mind's eye. I don't remember what the shot looked like, but it sure was scary, even when you're looking at it. I just remember that sequence. That little girl was so brave, and you're like, whoa, that's pretty cool. Here, maybe there's. Some of the bubbles. From the shark. They were just having fun. Rendering this thing. That would have been a fun movie to work on, The Meg. Great stuff. I could sort of have fun with that. But I just remember that shot, and if you're trying to get that little girl to pop a little bit, all I would do with her. I just throw in white to have her pop. The other thing we could do too, wanted to keep it simple, just have some of those glass, just to show it's like glass, like that. So I think that the shark started bouncing its snout against the glass and stuff. With the little girl. So there's the shark. There it is. Okay, just this real quick. There we go. Put the little girl back on there, and then there's our shot there. So pretty cool. Okay, so let's continue on telling our story. Let's pull this all together real quick. There's a shark. Okay. So we have that there. Cool. Okay, so what's our storyboard sequence we're gonna talk about today? So I've done a shot, sort of a a shot that I thought of from the Meg with a little girl. We just did that. We drew some sharks here. We had some shark drawings we drew. We have that little shot we were talking about over here. Let's get a new layer. Let's kick this off a little bit and see what we're gonna do. Okay, we gotta start off in the water somewhere. Because we know we're in the ocean. Cool. Let me think here. Get my pen going. So let's get our establishing shot going here. I'm just sort of thinking horizon line. Here. Just really thinking. Thinking of the water. Ocean. Keeping it simple. Maybe we have the sun out. Some clouds. We know where. No, we're in the ocean somewhere. Somewhere out there. And a little cheat way I do, I was going to do something else, but a little cheat way I do is I just grab your lasso tool. And I'll just quickly just go. Dump some color in it. And just get it so we got some watermarks there. What do I have here? Get some water in there. As we establish everything. We can do a couple of things. We can just go and just some cuts. We can do a shot like that. It doesn't need to be that. We can sort of also do some grids, you know, a shot like this, or even if you're thinking just sideways. So thinking perspective grids or something like that. Do something like this where it's like the shoreline. Ocean waves or whatever's coming there. See how this shot turns out. And that's what's cool about storyboarding, is work different things. See what works for you, what do you like. Like I'm not liking this shot right now. Like we were doing before here. Okay, so we got the water. See here. We can do different things here. Think of those basic shapes. Maybe there's a Think that maybe there's a diver. There's somebody out there. See how we can incorporate him. Chill chin of the guy. So the diver is think of that. Quint. Robert Shaw's character. Jaws. So maybe he's got a just sort of thinking real quick. Maybe he's in a little teeny Tampa boat. Listen, they're putting away into the boat, but we won't show that shot yet. Because we can do a couple of things here. Let's see, I got one, two. Let's get him here. So what I'm thinking right now is we won't show him yet. All we could do is grab. This is what's great about working digitally. You can do so many different things here. Okay, let's transform him. What I'm sort of doing is giving more of an establishing shot. I get a little bit more water. See what that did. All I'm thinking is just that. Something like that. All I'm thinking right now is like, all I'm going to do is put the boat into this sequence. There we go. Even go a third time here. Okay, so we have him come along, and then what we'll do. He's just a fisherman, so we're going to show him. Tugging along his boat. This is a little skiff here. See these guys got the things like that, but he'll be there. He's sitting there. We know he's gonna. Yeah, they're fishing somehow. Grab a little bit of, oops, didn't grab anything. Coming along here, we've got a little bit of the opposite side here. It's coming through. His boat. And then what we can do is copy this guy. Keep pushing them through. And he's pattern along. Then we have our guy here. A little different. Give him a little bit of attitude here. Is to that sticker right over his mouth. Let's put her along. Under the water, back here behind him, we got the engine smoke coming off the back of that engine. Some water in there. Just turn down some quick tone. As he's riding through, want to, we can add a bit darker tone on his clothes here. I'm quickly storyboarding. I'll do something like this to bring it together a little bit. And he's putting along. Okay, then what we can do, grab these layers, page one. Okay, so what do we have going on so far? Okay, so we start our first shot off. Got the open ocean. We see a little figure with a dinghy cruising along. Put, 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 put. Go screen right. We get a close up of the of our guy here, our fisherman. And then what we can do is what I'm thinking here is that what we'll do is we'll get a little bit close up of him. Scale. Like that. And we'll go ahead and trim all this. We're there. I got him looking down. So all I can do is come in here. Get that toothpick out of there too. Looks sort of scary like that. I'm looking. Okay, and then maybe. There we go, and he's got the boat here. Let's just say the boat's here. Get his boot. Trying to think where we can go with this. He's looking. tunes into that shot. Maybe he's looking at his hand. He's sort of thinking what he can be doing. He's thinking if he's baiting his hooks or. Doing something like that. Putting some bait on the hook. Thinking. Give him his pole. Just think he's gonna grab his fish. Put some fish on. Group these layers together. Okay, so what do we have here? So we started off here. Oops. Started off here with the ocean. There's a fisherman passing by, vroom, 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 going through. Get a medium shot of the fisherman putting away. What happened here? Raise that back up, cool. We're looking at the fisherman. Fisherman looks down. He's baiting his hook. He's got his fishing rod in his hand. He's got his line. He's got his bait. And then he's gonna cast out. So let's show him casting. Gotta have him do the wind up here. So let's get him sort of at a cool angle here. Here's his boat. He's gonna cast out here. KSL. Then what we can do is have that. As a bait hits the water. We're just sort of thumbnailing, nothing fancy, we're just trying to work through these boards to see what can we do with this sequence here. Splashes down. As we're thinking through this, maybe the next shot. Just the water. And then let's see here. Then we sort of have this. Right here. And all we're doing is getting that bait going down the water. page three. Okay, here we have the fisherman fishing, throws the fish in the water. Water. Fish comes down. Back to the top. We're going to say that this fish is right there, and we could show it by getting rid of these lines. Okay, maybe the lion is taunt now. And then could do have that there. Now that it sort of stayed still. Something like that. Okay, so we have that shark here. We know something's going through the screen, the shots. And let's, color this fish in real quick. What we're doing here, having our sharks swim by. Again. Swim by. Cool. And then what we'll do. Okay, so get that page knocked down. Check our chat real quick. Everybody's doing well. I got Kolaru says hello. How are you today? Thanks for joining in. Appreciate you joining in the live stream. If you're having some fun, please throw a like on the button there. Really appreciate it. Okay, let's recap. Because Kolaru just joined us real quick. I have page one. We sort of have the ocean out here. Ocean, an establishing shot. We have a fisherman coming through the shot. Piloting past, screen right. Get a close up of the fisherman. Then we got well, that was a medium shot. Then we're going to a close-up shot of the fisherman. He looks down. He's baiting his fish. Looks like he's after something pretty big. It's a pretty big fish. Gets his rod, ready to toss it out. Goes and casts out. Fish drops in the water. Get the under the water shot. Fish is going down in the water. Down, down, down. Fish continues to go down. Line gets taunt. Uh-oh. Something's lurking underneath. Shark is swinging by. See the tail, and it whips off. Okay, and our next shot. So I have it here. And let's go grab our shark. And then grab that one right there. And what we could do is we'll show the scale of how big this shark is. Something like that. Setting some mic tones here on this shark. Coming out. Okay, we got that. Now we have to go to that fisherman. I'm thinking that the fisherman has got to be like see how we're gonna do him here. So he should be something like this, with the boats here. Just sort of thinking here, he sort of. Trying to think of how I'm gonna do this shot. Like there's do something like that. He's sitting there fishing. I want to see is that line go. That line's gonna zip. The other thing we can do too is we can go like this, grab his line. Rotate it a little bit. Okay, it shakes a little bit. And then what we can do. Let's open up one of those layers. Grab him. Because now he has to look shocked. He's gonna be shocked he cut something. And now we can go. I'm gonna show that shark. who's from that chart. This. I'm not sure if it's going to have it. When the. So I got this shark grabbing onto his line. And Sharky's not happy. Shark's not happy. And I can go like this. Then we can do is get that next shot. Make that shot bigger. And that shark is not happy. The next shot we need is we need the fisherman. And he's got to be on his boat here. Thinking he's gonna have that body like he's gonna have that motion like that, so let's shrink that down a little bit. Gotta have that knee up, he's working that back. Edge of that boat. Spanish and he's like that on that string. And then what we could do. Okay. On this next one. We want that shark to get even meaner. He's gonna pull it. And what's gonna happen? He's gonna pull the fisherman into water. Well, I hope everybody's having a good time drawing along. Appreciate everybody joining. Got Gabby and Varrock and Kolaru. I know Ronnie couldn't make it tonight, but I appreciate her giving me a holler. Okay. Let's do this again. So now, gotta show the line. One the fisherman overboard. Have him accidentally. In the water. He goes in, splash. So then we need that. Shot like this. We'll do this layer. And we got the fisherman falling in the water. Coming down there in the water. Throw a couple more frames in here and call it a night. Let's see here. So we got this here, he's falling in. Okay, I got some sharks. That shark's gonna beeline to him. And then what I can do is grab the other shark here. Shark. Okay, so you got that shark. Come in here. Transform that real quick. Is a grab. Those two. Put that there. Quick. And this is gonna go here. Let's get this a little bigger here. our fisherman real quick. This page together. This guy. Oops. Wrong one. I lost a frame there. What happened? Gotcha. I missed a friend. So he's gonna be here. To there. Open this a little bit. A couple things we gotta do here. Gotta go. What are you gonna do? There. Okay, we're gonna make that up. Okay, just there. Okay. Better. Like that. Okay. holes in there. Like that. The shark is gonna go. And then we'll do finish it off. And then the last thing we might see. Is maybe we see the fisherman's cap. me see, the fisherman's cat float by. Okay, let's put this together. And let's review everything that we did tonight. Okay, let's review, friends. Let's see what we have here. Okay. So again, I appreciate everybody taking the time out of your busy day to hang out with me and sort of look at these. We put quite a few storyboards together for tonight, but I hope everybody enjoyed their time here. But let's go over this real quick. So we have the ocean here, and we have a fisherman puttering by in his dinghy. Get to see the fisherman here. He's looking at you. He looks straight down. He's baiting his hook with a big fish. Gets ready to cast out. Casts, makes a long cast. Bait hits the water. Fish is in the water, dropping down. Hits the end of the line, taunt line now. Something comes swimming by in the foreground, rushes by, bait's still sitting there. All of a sudden, big great white shark, hump! Fisherman sort of dozing here. And then all of a sudden his line starts shaking. He wakes up, shocked that he got a shark. Shark's twisting and turning and agitating in the water, ripping back and forth. He's fighting back and forth. Fish even fights harder. He holds back and boom, couldn't control it. Fisherman goes into the water. A splash. He falls in the water deeper and deeper. Shark comes closer and closer. He looks up. Shark is getting closer and closer. Dun, 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 dun. He screams. Shark comes at him. Goes to cuts to black. And all of a sudden, all you see is the hat floating in the water at the end. Okay, friends. I hope you had a great time tonight drawing with me, storyboarding with me. I appreciate everybody hanging out in the jam session tonight. Our jam session was all about sharks and shark films and that type of stuff. So really appreciate everybody hanging out with me tonight. I hope you had a good time. We produce these boards pretty quick. It's why we started at 11:45. It's been a few hours, but we created 9 pages of boards, and that was, I think, 4 or 5 shots per page that we did. So pretty good time frame, just making up a story, having fun. This is what I'd call my rough storyboards, or my sort of my thumbnails, and then I would go and edit this together and see how it flowed a little bit more, maybe draw a little bit better on the shots that I wanted to see a little bit better, and then would turn that in for approvals and then go on to my final boards from there. But anyways, like I said, I hope you enjoyed the session. If you enjoyed the session live here, please give this a like and please subscribe. If you're watching this on the replay, I ask you to do the same thing. Please subscribe. It lets me know that you guys support what I'm trying to do here and trying to offer some training, and I'm trying to share my journey, my processes with you. If they help you out, fantastic. I appreciate you taking the time to subscribe. I have over 20 hours worth of content so far. We've been doing this for about a month and a half right now, and I appreciate the gang of folks that are all coming on to hang out with me. I know I have my regulars here, and I really appreciate all of you supporting me each night as I'm talking through, because it's sort of like talking in a box, and I'm not, it'll be different if I was able to see everybody and talk to everybody, but I appreciate everybody dropping lines in that chat. So thank you so much. So I will see you again next week for our Mastering the Basics live stream on Tuesday. Looking forward to it. We'll probably continue our process on using that script with our thumbnails and roughs and do a little bit more work with that and off the script of Jurassic Time Loop, working with the astronauts that crash land on a futuristic or a prehistoric planet. So we'll go back to that on Tuesday. I hope you guys enjoyed our Shark Week today, and I can't wait to see your drawings. Please remember to share them with me. Give me a shout out or send it on the DM to me over on my Instagram account. I love seeing everybody's work. You guys do such a fantastic job, and every time I see folks' work, it's getting better and better each iteration you guys are doing of your work. So until we meet again, don't forget to keep going in your sketchbooks. Draw as much as you can. I'm looking forward to seeing everybody in the next video. And till then, I'll see you in the next one.